shorthand dictation, 120 words per minute, 7 minutes speed, 5 seconds. Now write down. The health of an organization depends on the policies it adopts, either with regard to its marketing, finance, purchase or personnel. It is no denying a fact that each and every branch mentioned above plays a very vital role in the growth and development of an industry. Today in this session, we shall be discussing one of the most important facets of management, that is personnel. The important indices which are used to know the level of the health of the organization are absenteeism, accidents, indiscipline and labor turnover. All these factors to some extent are dependent on the working conditions, the medical facilities and better industrial relations. There have been many studies taken up to analyze these factors of production. In the first place, it will be interesting to know that accidents are on the increase year after year as our emphasis on industrialization increases. An accident is considered to be fatal if there is a loss of life. Anything happening without the will of an individual is termed as an accident. The large number of industrial accidents not only cost the organization to a great extent, but also the human beings involved in such accidents. If there is an accident, on the one hand, the production is affected, and on the other hand, the indirect cost of financial expenditure to be incurred and the employees' medical care also increases. Thus, it is wise on the part of the administration to identify the areas prone to accidents and take remedial measures to prevent them as far as possible. The accidents may be of two varieties. They may be due to the carelessness of the worker at the time of work, and secondly, due to the lack of facilities in the work spot. There are arrangements which have to be constantly reviewed. The workers should be equipped with the proper tools, and the workplaces should have sufficient incandescence and ventilation. Further, the working hours of the company should be such as to give the worker enough rest, as fatigue also is one of the causes for the accidents. Thirdly, the workers should be given training at regular intervals. Despite all these measures, however, if an accident occurs, the management should not be content simply with the conduct of an inquiry and fixing the responsibility. It should take further steps to prevent its recurrence. The second factor which affects the industrial production is the rate of absenteeism. A person is said to be absent when he knows that he is to be present at the appointed time, at the appropriate place, and still avoids it for some reason or the other. Whatever may be the reason for one's absence, the company is the loser, in the sense that if it is not aware, the schedule of production is upset and the factory manager will be obliged to engage casual labor available at the gates. There is no guarantee that such contract labor may be as efficient as the one who should work on the machine. And once again, accidents may occur due to the fact that the occasional worker fails to follow the motion of the machines, the effects of which are sometimes costly. Many legislations in the connections have not given the results expected of them, and there are measures to be taken up further. Indiscipline is another factor which must be taken proper care of by the administration. The disciplinary rules of an organization should not be so harsh as to prompt a worker to show his dissent in any manner, while at the same time they should not be too liberal. On behalf of my country and on my behalf, I extend hearty congratulations to you on being elected to the distinguished post of President of the United States of America. I fervently hope that the relations between our two countries would grow from strength to strength in the years to come. During the past few years, our two countries have been emphasizing on the core issue of making the world a peaceful zone. The efforts done by your country in this direction are highly laudable, but still there are countries which have nuclear weapons, and the neighboring countries of such nations have the doubts that they would be used on them. It may not be out of place to mention that recently the aggression by a country on the neighbor has caused havoc not only to that country but also to the entire world. The weapons used caused not only large-scale destruction but also huge loss to the economies of the countries. It takes much time for any war-ravaged economy to recover. Even though there appeared to be peace between the two countries, the fire still burns. On behalf of my people, I extend to you my personal invitation to be part of the celebration of 50th Independence Day and to witness the enthusiasm of our people. The Indian ambassador will call on you to finalize your program. Looking forward to our cherished meeting. Yours sincerely,